Hello everybody. Today I decided that I'm going to integrate TrueNAS with Proxmox. So in order to do that, we'll need to go to the configuration of each one of the two servers, and we will then take storage from the Proxmox, TrueNAS, and attach it to our Proxmox. Let's do that. So this is external storage. So I'm going to be using a web browser. As you can see, on both of these two, we have both of these two servers. We have a web interface that we allow, that we can use. I'm just going to So I'm connecting to the one machine. Wait. 1, 2, 1, 3, 1. That is the TrueNAS machine. Yesterday I built this machine, and in the last video I built this machine, this VM, and it has got our TrueNAS on. If you you can watch that video in the tab below or tab above. It's one of the machine the videos in our playlist. Then the second one, I'm going to maximize this, is to connect to our Proxmox. So it's 192.168.122. See if I can find the Proxmox over there. I cannot. 32.94. Okay. Colon. 006, but that is HTTPS. Now, it will ask, give you the error that you can't connect to it. As you can see, I changed the theme on this one to a dark theme. Let's log in with a simple password that I created. This is it. Yes, there we go. So, I'm going to change the theme back because I'm just used to the other theme. So, my theme, apply. There we go. That works for me. Anyway, if you look at the storage that's attached to this physical host, this one is called VH00. There's local storage for this one and local storage for the, for the VMs. I believe this is where this local one will be used for backups and ISO images. We have one ISO image called DSL. Anyway, the second one is where we would keep the disks for each VM that is created. However, this is on the local drive for this physical machine, which if that machine gives a problem, and we need to shut it down, then all the VMs that reside on it will also end up going down. So what we'll do today is add more storage. So if you click on data center, firstly, let's go to the storage on TrueNAS. Yesterday, in the previous video, we created a link, a data set and that we can share. So if you go through the previous video, you'll see how we went about that share. Here we go. This is the share we created. And one of the important parts that needs to be, maybe what we can do is recreate the share. So I'll destroy the share so that you can see what it is, how we went about it. Let's create, add a share. The path will automatically fill in if you select the path here. We'll just do that. That's the path we're going to be using. And description is optional, and we do, however, have to go to the advanced options. We'll go here, and there's a area here where we have to select the root user. Let's just take another look. Yes, I think that should do it. Security, no, that's not it. Let's see, I think should do it. I'm gonna do that. Now there is a area where we have to define. Oh, here we go. We can add the host or we add a network. I'm going to add the network, which is 192.168.122.0/24. I think that's, I don't know why. Oh, sorry, that's the reason. That's 0 and then 24 over here. Go, and that should allow all activity on that particular host. So now this Proxmox host should be able to obtain the storage for or connect to that storage. So we'll click on data center, then we will click on storage, and here we will click on add storage, add, and we'll select NFS. Here we'll give it a name. I'll just give it VMS. The IP address is the one on that, on the TrueNAS server, 8.122.131, I think. 131, and it's going to, if I select it, it's scanning, can't seem to see it. I think I may have to specify the permissions. Just add a host here. I'll do this 192.168.122. I think it's 94. Let's make it 94. Save. Find it now. Full scanning. See it. Oh, sorry. That's the reason. 122. Now I should be able to find it. There we go. Okay, so I'm going to say that this must be disk images. So if image, I'll just disk images for now. And I suppose we can do something else as well. We can add ISO onto it as well, and even backups, because this is just a temporary play area for our server. So there we go. So now, thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe and check out the rest of our channel. Previous videos will help to understand the current one. Thank you. Bye.